Good morning, students. I am Amlesh Kumar. Today, I am going to discuss about the palindrome number. What is a palindrome number and how we can check any number that number is palindrome or not. So, it's a basic program. So, let's see in this video. After just watching this video, the concept of palindrome number and the program, I hope it will be clear to all. So, this program, see here, program to enter a number and check if it is a palindrome or not. The first thing that we must know that what is a palindrome number. Palindrome number means the number when we reverse and the after reversing that number, if we are getting the same number, that is called the palindrome number. For example, 1 to 1. 1 to 1, and when we reverse this 1 to 1, we will get 1 to 1. Hence, we can say this 1 to 1 is a palindrome number, because when we reverse this one, we will get 1 to 1. Now, take another example. If we are taking number 1 to 3, and when we reverse this number 3 to 1, so number, the original number is 1 to 3, and when we are reversing this one, then we are getting 3 to 1. So the original number 1 2 3, and after reversing number is 3 to 1. So we cannot say this 1 2 3 is a palindrome number. Okay, so this is called the palindrome number. Once again, justly say, when we reverse the number and if we are getting the same number, then we can say the number is palindrome. And if we are not getting the same number, we cannot say that is a palindrome number. So let's come and see. Practically, we will learn this thing. See the first line, this is the comment in the Python. I have written here the program to enter a number and check if it is a palindrome number or not. So this line will not execute. I have already discussed this thing. So here one line is written, enter a number, means we have to take number from the user, and for this we have an input function, and we are writing here, we have written here, enter any number, means this line, after executing this line, one number will be requested to the user, and when number entered by user, that number will assign in variable add. Now this one n1, I have declared another variable, and the value of n1 will be add. Means whatever the value user will enter, that will assign in variable add, and that value of n will copy into n1. Means after executing this one, the value of n1 and n both are same. Now another variable I have taken, reverse, rev equal to 0, because remember how we can check, there is only one logic behind it. We need to reverse that number and then we will have to check with the original number. So we need a variable to store the reversing number. So that's why I have declared here reverse and I have assigned here 0. Means after executing these three lines, the value of n, whatever user will assign, and value of n1 will be same as n1, and reverse is 0. Now here I am going to check the condition. While n greater than 0, yes, if n greater than 0, then we need to do this operation. Why I have written this dig? Dig is another variable. And why I have written this and mod region thing? So let's see, I am going to explain. Now we all know 1 2 3 and modulo division 10, then after executing this line, the value of c will be 3. Just try to understand. Then 1 2 modulo division 10, then value of c will be 2, and c equal to 1 modulo division 10, then the value of c is 1, and here the original number is 1 2 3. Just I have taken one example, and if we modulo division by 10 this number, then we will get the last digit, and after just taking the last digit, then 2 digit will be here, and when we again divide modulo division by 10, it will return the remainder, that is 2 and then 1. So see, we are getting the digit, and obviously we are getting the reverse number also. So this is the concept, means how we can get the individual digit, and if we will get the individual digit, then we can reverse it. So that's why I have declared one variable diz and here and what we obtain. So suppose if the value of n is 1, 2, 3, so 1, 2, 3 what we obtain, so it will return the remainder. The remainder will be 3. So here diz equal to 3. Now reverse into 10. Initial value of reverse is 0. Reverse into 10, it will be 0. And diz is right now 3. If we will take the value of n is 1, 2, 3, so here diz is 3. Means after executing this line, 0 plus 3 means 3, it will assign in reverse. So diz is 3 here, reverse is 3 here. Now see here, n divided by 10, so it will return the quotient. The value of n is 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3 divided by 10 means quotient will be 12, and it will be converted to integer and assigned to the n, because loop ko update karna jaruri hai. So now after executing the first time while loop, the value of diz is 3, reverse is 3, and n is 12. After executing this line, once again the program control will switch to the condition part of the loop. Means 12 greater than 0, yes. In second time, this line will execute and mod division 10, the value of n is 12. 12 divided by 10 means remainder will be 2, so diz will be 2 here. Now this line will execute. Reverse is right now 3, 3 into 10 is 30, and diz is here 2, so 30 plus 2, it will be 32, and that 32 will assign in the variable reverse. Now once again 12 divided by 10, quotient will be 1, and that 1 will assign in and. Once again the program control will switch to this part, 1 greater than 0, yes, condition is true. Then diz equal to n mod division 10, means n right now 1, 1 mod division 10, it will be 1, means value of diz will be 1. Then reverse is right now 32, 32 into 10, it will be 320, plus diz is here 1, means 320 plus 1, it will be 321, means value of diz will be, reverse will be 321. Now 1 mod division 10, quotient will be 0, it will assign here 0, means value of n is 0. Once again program control will switch to this part, 0 greater than 0, condition is false, so this while loop will be terminated. So after just finishing this loop, value of reverse is 321. So now n1 is here 1, 2, 3, because whatever the value user has entered, that is copied in the n1. So n1 means 1, 2, 3 equal to reverse, reverse is 321, so the condition is false. Means if condition is false, so this line will not execute, so obviously else part will execute. So just this message will print, number is not the print ROM. Let's, I'm going to run this one and see the result, what will the result. It's asking enter any number, so I have entered here 1, 2, 3, and we know 1, 2, 3 is not the reverse number, not the print ROM number. So see, number is not the print ROM number. Once again I'm going to execute this number, and I'm going to enter here 1, 2, 1. When we reverse this number, so we will get the 1, 2, 3, means obviously this number will be print ROM number. So see, number is print ROM. So this is all about the print ROM number. Watch this program, watch this video carefully, try to understand, and if you face any problem, you can raise the question. Thank you.